Coming up next on ATETV, Electromechanical Engineering.
I am the one who will go and install the machine for them and train them how to use it.
Biotechnology.
I wanted to be part of a community of people that is rapidly developing.
In between the filters and the stuff.
And recruiting future engineers right out of high school.
We need to begin to develop the technical expertise and the technical skills in a much younger child so that they have a chance and to help us create a global competitive environment.
Now on ATETV. From across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Wondering what your career might look like after completing a degree in electromechanical engineering technology? Well, let's have a look at what Travis is doing after graduating from Florence Darlington Technical College.
I'm Travis Blackwell. I'm a field service engineer for welding automation with ESOB equipment. Customer purchases a machine from ESOB. I am the one who will go and install the machine for them and train them how to use it. The two-year degree that I graduated with was electromechanical engineering technology.
That's only one way to go in.
Technical college essentially taught me how to think for a higher level, problem solving, and to do any sort of analysis whatsoever.
Got the negative going to the ring.
The hands-on training did help a lot with establishing good fundamentals for the lectures. My internship here helped me get a lot more familiar with the ESOB equipment. I wired up the electrical cabinets that you see the big black box behind me. A lot of my friends are jealous because I was able to find a great job and improve myself financially and career-wise.
Travis is doing great with his high-paying technical career, and the job opportunities in engineering are endless. If this is something you might be interested in, be sure to check out the technology opportunities available at a community college near you. Always had a love of science? Well, it's never too late to change your career. You might consider studying to become a biotechnology engineer. Susan Clark has decided to go back to school to prepare for a new career in that rapidly growing field.
My name is Susan Clark, and I'm a student here taking my second biotechnology course to fulfill a goal that I've been trying to get to, getting a biotechnology certificate. My job that I had been busy with for 12 years ended, which has taken me to a three-pronged approach. First of all, my love of science, and the second part is developing a new set of skills that'll get me out into the workforce. And thirdly, I wanted to be part of a community of people that is rapidly developing.
We've got it right at 1.25 speed, which we calculated the day before.
Coming back to college wasn't hard for me because I had a definite goal and I wanted to achieve that goal. There were several people in my class who were just about my age. One was retired, looking for something else to do. Another one was, you know, he was switching jobs due to layoffs. So we had something in common there. And anybody, if you meet in this biotech situation, they're all enthusiastic and they love what they do. This would allow me to go out into the workforce, to biotechnology companies, and apply for jobs. I'm interested in quality control, environmental monitoring. Now, maybe I feel a little more adventurous.
Very important part.
Yeah.
Susan is busy earning her biotechnology certificate and will soon have a high-tech career. If you want to learn more about biotechnology or biomanufacturing, be sure to check out your local community college. If you want to get a jump on earning college credit while still in high school, community colleges all across the country can help.
When I was in high school, we took a drafting program, and that started my ambition for architecture.
I took a few electronic classes in high school. I took a class called mechatronics, working with mechanical and electronics.
We would have more students come directly into the program if they understood how important it is in high school.
So that when the child graduates high school, they can just flow right into the technical education.
Didn't know how to do any electrical work, so I took some high school and it kind of got me into messing around with it, so that's why I ended up here doing it.
I often go into high schools and I'll say to the students, find something in this room that an engineer or an engineering technician was not involved in. Who decided what the walls were going to be made out of? Why are they wooden sometimes and concrete sometimes? Who decided how many air conditioning vents there were going to be and how many lights there were going to be and how the power was going to get here? There's almost nothing that you can think of that some kind of engineer doesn't have something to do with.
Give negative power to that.
By introducing this at the high school level, they have a better feel for what type of career that they would like to embrace and pursue.
On this point, 15.00.
I actually took a mechanical drawing class in high school, following behind my boyfriend. I just got hooked on it ever since.
We make visits into the high school, but we don't go sit in the cafeteria. We go into upper level math and science classes. We take students with us, especially somebody who's graduated from that high school who can say, get that good math and science foundation in high school so that you can come straight to the college and graduate in 2 years.
When I see other students and they share their feelings on the school, I say that, you know, I would like to feel that also, so that's what motivated me to come here.
It's very important for students who want to come straight into the programs here at Florence John and Tech to get a really good foundation before they get to Tech.
If you get focused early enough, you take the right classes, you choose wisely, then you're going to be prepared for a good career, for a bright future.
We need to begin to develop the technical expertise and the technical skills in a much younger child so that they have a chance to help us create a global competitive environment.
All education needs to lead to employment so that not only are they more directed, but they have more purpose in their learning.
I had a teacher over in my high school and he recommended I go to Florence Sovereign Tech. I said, sure, that's for me.
Those students knew they were interested in math, science, and technology while still in high school and are now turning that interest into a high-paying career. Be sure to visit your local community college for programs that will help you earn college credit while still in high school. For more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at atetv.org. Thanks for watching.